igama lami ngimthemba ngawo nyoko qansa iqabele khona le ezintabeni ngifuna oqhamo endleleni ngahlangana neqaqa liqaqe lazi laqhamo qhoqhoqho.
Oh my dear Themba, I have so many historical memories of you. The one that we constantly shared was about your grandpa and the strange remedies he offered to heal your ailments. However, despite all the weirdness, you had such deep respect for him and was so grateful that he took you in and cared for you. Another memory that made my heart sing was when you worked in a production with Jess Newpin and you were rehearsing with her team at Moving Into Dance. I came into the studio to chat with Jess. You walked out in the middle of rehearsal to give me the warmest hug ever. Such fond memories. The world has not lost just a talented dancer and choreographer, but a human being who had no pretensions, was so grateful for all his training at MID that he always gave back with no reservation or expectation. And one who always remembered that MID was his home, and he always came home. I miss you, Themba. Your family at MID misses you. Dance through the skies, old friend. Dance through the skies.
Hello, I'm Sylvia Glasser from Moving Into Dance. First of all, I'd like to express my deepest sympathy to Themba's family, to Lauren, to his colleagues at the Unmute Dance Company and Broken Borders, and to all his friends and whoever knew him. Themba came to Moving Into Dance in 2007 as a full-time student in our training course. He stood out because of his creativity, his eagerness to learn, but also his kindness, his generosity, his gentleness, and especially his potential as a choreographer. In 2009, we invited Themba to come back to Moving Into Dance to be a member of the performing company. During this time, I realized that we had in him an extraordinary choreographic ability. He choreographed a dance with four MID dancers titled Dark City. This dance was so powerful, was so deeply emotional. It was original. The subject matter was innovative, and it was breathtaking to watch. This was the first of many innovative dances that he created, and especially his solo, Dark Cell. While at Moving Into Dance, as part of his teaching practice, Themba taught bi-weekly at a junior primary school in Zola. He created wonderfully delightful, imaginative dances with the children. The children and the teachers at the school loved him so much that when he left Johannesburg, we were unable to replace him. They didn't want to accept anyone else. When he left Moving Into Dance, Themba kept in touch with me. Whenever he was in Johannesburg, he came to visit all of us at Moving Into Dance. And when he was performing, he would always invite me and eagerly await my feedback. He often expressed his gratitude, and I was deeply moved in 2015 when he invited me as one of his limited number of guests to the award ceremony of the Standard Bank Young Artists, for which he was one of them for 2016. Themba has left us much too soon, but he's left an amazing and absolutely extraordinary legacy. Themba is loved by so many, including me.
Cross the world like an arrow.
Jesu fika kuseni Sebenzi makandile nga webusuku Afika kuseni Ezokupha amandla amasha Jesu fika kuseni Sebenzi makandile nga webusuku Afika kuseni Ezokupha amandla amasha Ngiyana somebody Ufika kuseni Sebenzi makandile ngawe ebusuku Afika kuseni Ezokupha amandla amasha
Yes, Jesus. Dear Themba, dear friend, dear mentor, thank you for the past 10 years of being present in my life. Your presence has been a real present, a gift filled with love, generosity, care, honesty, and lots of positive energy and attitude. Hearing of your passing has left me with no words. All I can say is thank you for being a part of my life, and may your soul rest in peace. And to your friends and loved ones, may you be strengthened by God's guidance. Love, Julia Senzi Burnham.
Thobela, kalibitso ke Teresa Phuthi wa Gamojela. It's tough. It's not easy. I'm not okay. And I'm not ready for this. I was never ready. And yeah. Thank you, Moving Into Dance, for really, that's where I met Themba, because if it wasn't because of the training program, I wouldn't have met Themba. I think it was 2007, if not 2006. Yeah, it's like 14 years me and Themba have known each other. And we went to Inzalo training program together, that was 2008. And our relationship, myself and Temba's relationship, was of that a brother and a sister. One thing I've learned is that with Themba is that blood, is that family is not only by blood. Yeah, they say blood is thicker than water, but water is powerful. And we've done our first piece together, Dark Cell. I was part of it, I performed, and I helped Themba to create the piece. So it was our first baby. And then the second piece that we also created together, it was Sold, where he won the Standard Bank Young Artist in Dance. And yeah, Themba, he was like a family. Themba, he is my everything. I used to call him my young kinto, and then I called him Timbuli, and he would call me Teria Puti. I'm gonna miss that. That's tough. He is my pillar of strength. He is, even now, he is, and he's gonna stay forever being in the pillar of my strength. And to the whole family, to the friends, to Lauren, sending my condolences to you, to them Moving Into Dance, to an unmute family, I'm sending my condolences, and to my family as well, because we are all shattered. My mom, my dad, my siblings, they are all shattered. Themba was like their son. Themba is their son. It's tough. I've never imagined that one day I will talk about his life in past tense. It's tough. I was never ready for this day, and I don't know how I'm gonna move from here. But I know for sure one day, taking each day as it comes. And oh man, I'm gonna miss his guidance. I'm gonna miss his funny laugh. I'm gonna miss him staring at me, and I'm gonna miss his guidance. And he played an important role in my career, not only in my life, but in my career as well. He was the person that would guide me everything. All the decisions that I make, I have to go through him first. I have to go get his guidance and all that. Like, we'll discuss, and I'm gonna miss our long video calls, our 2 to 3 hours video calls and calls. And yeah, I've lost a pillar of my strength. I've lost a huge part of me. Themba loved me unconditionally. I've experienced his love. Themba had a big heart. His soul was just like amazing. He was humble, very crazy person, talkative as well, and pretending to be shy at some point. And one thing that we agreed on was that he would speak Sotho, Spedi, and I would speak Zulu. And thank you so much, Themba, for the time I've spent with you, and thank you for the love that you gave me. You've shown me so much love. I've learned what is love through you as well. And amen. And thank you so much. I'm glad that I had to take you to my home in Limpopo. You were there, and the whole family, they are shattered so much by your passing. And to Lauren, I'm here. To Pindi, I'm here. We are here, all of us. To the Broken Borders, Majida, hang in there, hold it. To the people that they've always wanted to work with Themba, if you need Temba's legacy, if you need to know more about Temba's work, there's Broken Borders, get a hold of them. They will really be of a great assistance in that. We are here, I'm here. His first work, Dark Cell, Dark City, and then Into the Dark Cell. I know everything about the Dark Cell. I was part of it. I was part of the creation team. And amen. To the whole, to his family, my condolences to you all. I need a month and a year to talk about Themba's life. I've lost a brother. I've lost a part of me. Someone that never pretend to love me. Someone that we never fought. Myself and Themba, we never fought. For these 15 years that we've been together, I've never, we never, I don't even remember, not even once, that we found ourselves fighting, that we found ourselves not talking to each other. No. And in the morning, Themba will just call me and say, just to tell me how much he loves me. He's that person. In the morning, I will wake up to a text. In the evening, I will sleep into a text, and Themba saying, you know, how much he loves me. And I would say that back. Or sometimes I would just call him to tell him that I love him and I miss you. Come back home. And, you know, all that. And thank you so much to the Cape Town artist industry, to the Cape Town artist. You've given Themba a home. You've welcomed Themba with warm hearts. To the Unmute dance company, my condolences to you. Let's hold each other. Let's hold hands. Themba has left his life. Themba, he has lived his life. Themba, he has played an important role into each and everyone's life. Themba, he has touched everyone's life differently and in a special way.
I was raised by my grandmother and my grandfather because my mother passed away when I was still young. I think I was around 7 years. It was a little bit rough, but being raised and groomed by a strong woman like my grandmother, she really prepared me for the world with her teachings, with her love, with her care. I met this guy who became my mentor, Kent Ekberg from Sweden. He's the one who really helped me to say, you know what, you've got a talent, but you need to learn how you channel your talent. So he took us one day to Newtown. There's a school called, it's a company and a college as well called Moving Into Dance. I remember seeing these young boys and girls dancing on stage. They were flying. I remember seeing Fana Shabalala. He was also one of the Standard Bank winners. He was just flying on stage. I was like, wow, I wish one day I can do that, because you don't even need words to express what you want to say. You can just do that with your body. I trained for about a year there, and it was difficult because I didn't have any dance background, and I was a laughing stock sometimes because I couldn't do some things right when they were saying point. I used to do funny things with my feet. So for me to be in dance, so it's like a therapy for me. It washes away all that baggage that I carry with me from my past, in my present situations, and whatever that I come across today. It really liberates me. We co-founded this dance company called Unmute Dance Company, where we're working with integrated arts, people with disability and without disability. So it's not just a company, but it's a movement for us. So for me, by far, this is the best highlight of my career as an artist, as an activist, as a performer, as a choreographer. I met someone, Nadine McKenzie. She's my fiance now. She's in a wheelchair. She's also a dancer in the company, and she's one of the co-founders of Unmute Dance Company. I use history to try to access our current situation, especially in South Africa. Dance for me, it's a language. My next step moving forward is to really reach Africa as a whole with this kind of work that we're doing, so that there is no one left behind. I'd like to thank the National Arts Festival in Grahamstown and the Standard Bank for giving us this platform, especially as young artists, to showcase our talent, to show what we can offer to South Africa and the rest of the world, especially. Yeah, thank you very much. And I feel really humbled and honored to be one of the people who are selected to be honored by this award.
Home again, back where we belong again. We hold. coming home.